CryptoCat is a piece of software that works in your browser. We're trying to make a piece of chat software. It's as easy to use, as accessible as Facebook chat or Google Talk or any software like that, but it preserves your privacy. It encrypts your conversations automatically. So when you're using it, it's just as easy to use as any other chat software in the browser, but your conversations are automatically encrypted and they're kept private, more private than Facebook chat. So I said web browsers. Internet Explorer is not a web browser, so it doesn't work in Internet Explorer. Just Internet Explorer is really, really inaccessible to developers. So developing for it is impossible, really. And making CryptoCat for Internet Explorer is really a very bad idea, because Internet Explorer is not a medium for making something like CryptoCat. The browser itself is barely a medium for CryptoCat at all. So we are relying on browsers with better technologies built in, like Chrome, Firefox, and Safari. And hopefully Opera soon. You need encryption simply to preserve to secure your right for privacy. You don't really need encryption, you know, necessarily to overthrow a government or to, you know, set up a revolution, but you might simply, for example, I use CryptoCat to talk to my girlfriend, right? And people, for example, LGBTQ individuals use CryptoCat to talk to counselors. A middle school teacher that sent me an email uses CryptoCat to teach her students about internet privacy. So it's just a matter of securing your privacy for whatever purpose. It's simply, because on the internet, quite simply, when you're using Facebook chat or Google Talk, you don't have privacy. But the thing is, you should. You should, but you don't. And so CryptoCat is means to be an alternative when you do. And so that means that while it offers better privacy than, say, Facebook chat, it's not really an alternative to security software and encryption software that's been there for 20 years. You know? It's a new project, it's an experimental project, but it has some real results and uses for a lot of people.
Some people think that big companies like Facebook and Google are threats to our privacy, but as you explained, they're not actually the threat, they're just providers.
Right. So the real threat is actually government policy. If you want to eliminate the threat to privacy, you attack government policies. Google and Facebook are facilitators. Yes, they're the aggregators of your data, but they didn't aggregate your data in order to survey it. They aggregated your data in order to provide a service, and you know it's kind of innocent what they did. But what happens is that this ends up being exploited by governments who realize, oh, we now have this couple of companies that have a big aggregate of user data, and they exploit this to monitor the data, and then Google and Facebook end up facilitating this process. So the real problem here is government policy and international communities not condemning this sort of thing as much as they should. But also, if you want to protect yourself, it might be smart to not use Facebook or Google for sensitive things. So I use Facebook myself, but I use it only for very casual public things. I don't use it to have private conversations or anything.
What we're trying to do with CryptoCat is that we're trying to explore the limits of how much we can make encrypted software accessible. So if you know how to use Facebook chat, if you know how to use Google Talk, if you know how to use Skype, then you already know how to use CryptoCat. If you speak any one of 35 languages around the world, English being only one of them, then you already know how to understand the CryptoCat interface. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to develop this piece of software that runs in any web browser, is available in 35 languages, and you can use it to chat, with random people, friends, group chat with up to like 10 people, private chat one-on-one, and also send files, images and zip files and so on. If you're a new user for CryptoCat, it's actually that's the accessible part. It's just you go to the CryptoCat website, you download app for your web browser, so for Chrome or Firefox or Safari, you download something for it, and it takes 5 seconds, and then you can just click on the CryptoCat icon in your browser, and then you just enter a chat room and you chat, and everything is encrypted automatically.
Without password, anything?
No, there's actually no stable identity, so there's no username, no password, it's just you enter a nickname for yourself, and the name of the room you want to join, and it doesn't remember anything about you. So it's actually both a good thing and a bad thing in security, because it's a good thing because it doesn't remember anything about you, but it's a bad thing because that means that the identity of your keys, of your encryption keys, because there's a way to verify your encryption keys, and so the identity of your encryption keys will change every time which means that you will have to verify your identity to other people via your encryption keys every time, which sounds kind of complicated. But basically it means that every single time people aren't sure it's you, so they have to make sure it's you that they're talking to, because every single time the program resets its information about you.
Ovdje sam došla da napravimo ponovo revoluciju, pošto evo već treći put pravimo, znači dva puta u Beogradu, Share Conference, jednom u Beirutu i evo sad, baš mi je drago što sam u Rijeci ovim povodom. Bitni su ovakvi događaji zato što mi ne nosimo svi ono roze naočare i kao pravimo se da je svesni smo da se nešto događa, ali nismo svesni šta se tačno događa. Ovdje dobijamo tačan primjer onoga što se događa u svetu, što nas čeka, što se već dogodilo kod nas i ono što je najbolje za nas, mislim, na Balkanu je što već rješenje postoji u svetu, a mi samo treba da ga primenimo.